can see it beat, intoxicating your energy. First time in so long you felt the heat.
Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. I did say in the last video that I was back, however thanks to COVID it sort of put a stop to that. As you all know, we were put back in a lockdown in the UK, so we couldn't really go anywhere. And to be honest, I've been having to think about my channel and I don't want to do repetitive videos. I mean, you've seen Nuki Town on my previous video up there and you've seen pretty much all the surrounding areas, what I've done already. So I came to the conclusion that my channel's not about that. It's about going out and exploring the unknown. That's why it's called Odyssey Xplore. It's to have an adventure and to see new things. And I don't want you guys to keep seeing the repetitiveness on my channel. So we're gonna be starting branching out now. Obviously the restrictions are gonna be lifted very, very slowly. And we can now travel further afield and see places that I haven't seen and you haven't probably seen. And I believe that way we can get the channel to what it should be and get it producing content that I believe is why I started YouTube in the first place. So without further ado, we're going to head to the location. I'll tell you more about it when we're there. But we also have a surprise guest who is one of the actual founding members of Odyssey Xplore. He's back and hopefully he'll be coming on a lot more adventures with us. So yeah, we'll head to the location and we'll see you there. Here he is, the man of the moment, the man of the hour. He's here.
Could do that much.
What you got there?
Sausage sandwiches.
Oh, he's bought the goodies.
I have. Bet mine though. So it's just yours.
Right everyone, we've arrived at the location. Like I said, I was going to explain it a bit more when we got here. The place that we're at is called Helman Tor. It is in line with the Saints Way, which is linked to our Roach Rock video, which is another video that Luke did with us. The views from here are immense, so we're going to go add up to the top of the tour and we're going to try and get the drone up. It's not as windy as I thought it would be today, so we're in luck. Like I said, the views are stunning. Look at that. We're going to head up to the tour now. Luke's having fun on a gate. But we're going to head up there and I'll tell you a bit more about the place we are when we're up there.
Champagne Perrier, finished friends on my face. Looking like I'm from the deep, these no Cartiers. Pockets deep, 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 bro. I can make it in my seat, bro. Do you, I'm doing me, bro. Making noise, use a beat.
Right, we've walked up a little bit of the tour, but I thought the best way to give you the full experience is by air. Set the drone up, we're gonna send it up. It's perfect conditions for the drone, so yeah, we're gonna send it up now and let's see what you think. Well, I hope you enjoyed that drone footage. It's not windy as what I thought it would be, so the drone coped with it pretty well. But we're just heading up to the top of the Torr where you saw on the footage, and hopefully the view from up there is as magnificent as it is at the moment. But the Torr itself is obviously a saint site or something like that. It's in the saint view or the saint lane or something. And from what the footage showed you on the drone, you could obviously see all the rocks were stacked on top of each other. Now, I read on the internet that apparently the rocks were put there by someone. They weren't just geologically formed. They were actually placed on top of each other. So I don't know who's done it, but I'm telling you now, I couldn't lift that. Just to get a little bit of perspective of how big these rocks actually are, my good friend Luke is going to go and stand by one of these rocks just so you can get a size perspective of how big these rocks are.
They are huge.
Massive.
Big old rocks.
You tell me how someone has lifted those rocks up, and it obviously isn't going to be recent because they look like they've been there for thousands of years. My guess, aliens. Right, we've reached the top of the Torr, pretty much the top of the Torr. We're just going to walk up to the little monument. I believe it's got a cross on it or something to obviously symbolise the saint's way. But we're going to have a walk up there and have a look at that, see what the view is like from there. So we made it to the top. And that's your view. What did you say? Yeah, that doesn't look very good. Let's investigate. Strange. Looks like an alien peace offering.
It's got to be.
Well, from photos I've seen on the internet, I thought there was a cross on this monument, but it actually turns out it's an anarchy symbol, as you can see. It's like the complete opposite of Jesus and saint-like. So, that's your view, which is immense. And we were just saying, you can see from here, you can pretty much see near enough coast to coast down Cornwall, over in the distance there. There you can see the sea over there, but that's over by St Austell, and then in the far distance over there is Dartmouth and Bodmin Moor, which will be coming soon. We are planning a visit up there, obviously, when all the restrictions go down and we can travel further afield. Like I said earlier in the intro, we'll be going up there and doing a little camping trip, which will be quite interesting, wouldn't you say? But yeah, we're going to have a little walk around, see what else we can see, get some cinematic shots, and I think that'll be probably about it. Sorry this video's been a bit shorter, but I hope you enjoyed it. Look at that one. Talk about a balancing act, Jesus.
I'll kick it off.
Go on then, kick it, see what happens. A lot happened there, mate. Thank you. Right, everyone, I hope you enjoyed that video. We've explored pretty much the whole of the Torr now. I would recommend this to people because the walk, like I say, is stunning, and the views, you can see them for yourself, they're brilliant. As of an exploring rating out of 10, what would you give it, Luke?
I'd give it a 7.
7?
A 7.
Yeah, I'd say a 7's pretty reasonable, isn't it?
Yeah.
Like I say, there's not really much to explore here, but the views and sort of the scenery and everything sort of outweighs the cons of coming to this place. And it is a lovely drive up here as well. So, again, sorry for the wait, I do apologise, but due to obviously the times we're in, it's a bit hard to do anything at the moment. But it's good to have Luke back on the channel.
Yeah.
Hopefully we'll be doing a lot more videos very, very soon. Don't forget to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. We're very, very close to 300 subscribers at the moment, which I can only thank you from the bottom of my heart. It's really, really, really good to see people enjoying my videos and enjoying the content. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Odyssey XPLORE out. Eternal.